Hello. I am speaking to you from a secure location because I have a message that big electromagnetism doesn't want you to hear. But the truth cannot be silenced. I am a believer, and soon you will be too, because you deserve to know the facts they won't teach you about in school. So listen very carefully. Magnetic monopoles are real.
We need to talk about magnets. Now, I don't own a bar magnet, so this stick of butter is going to have to do. See, it has a north pole and a south pole, and if you hold the north pole near a south pole, they attract. But see how the north pole and the south pole are attached to each other? This is called a magnetic dipole because there are two poles. And even if I cut the bar magnet in half, each half still has both a north pole and a south pole, still a dipole. A magnetic monopole would be just a north pole or just a south pole by itself. Now this bar magnet will never get there, no matter how many times I cut it in half. But are magnetic monopoles out there? Magnetism goes hand in hand with electricity, and there are electric monopoles. We normally call them electric charges. Electrons have negative charge, protons have positive charge. A magnetic monopole would have north charge or south charge.
The electric and magnetic fields are described by Maxwell's equations. When there's no charges around, Maxwell's equations put electricity and magnetism on perfect equal footing. It is beautiful and symmetrical and just how it ought to be. But when you introduce electric charges without introducing magnetic monopoles, that symmetry is ruined. It's totally unfair to magnetism. The only way to restore balance is by having magnetic monopoles. And that alone is like already enough to convince me. I mean, if you're going to have electric charges, you should also have magnetic charges, and that's just how it should be. There are those who will tell you that magnetic monopoles have never been convincingly detected, but this is also a part of the conspiracy. In fact, there are magnetic monopoles all around us, but they've been insidiously disguised as electric monopoles by big electromagnetism. They're doing it by exploiting a special property of Maxwell's equations to pull the wool over your eyes. Don't let them fool you. See, Maxwell's equations, the version with magnetic charges, possess a special property that they remain unchanged if you redefine the electric and magnetic fields and the electric and magnetic charges in a particular way. Let's say I make a plot with electric charge on the x-axis and magnetic charge on the y-axis. I can place particles on this plot, like the electron has electric charge minus E and magnetic charge zero. Big electromagnetism wants you to believe that all particles are restricted to this horizontal electric charge axis. They have electric charge, but no magnetic charge. There are no magnetic monopoles. But guess what? It turns out that if we rotate every particle's position on this plot while also redefining the electric and magnetic fields with a corresponding rotation, Maxwell's equations stay the same. They describe the same physics. That means that even though electric and magnetic charge are usually defined such that the plot looks like this, this rotated version is actually equally valid. And look at this. If you pick these rotated quantities, these particles have magnetic charge. They're magnetic monopoles. In fact, we could even rotate everything 90 degrees and then all particles fall on the magnetic charge axis. Then there's no electric monopoles. Of course, no one ever uses those rotated quantities because big electromagnetism has shut down free thinking. The choice to define electric and magnetic charge the way we usually do is just a convention carefully selected to deny magnetic monopoles. Now, granted, it is also a convention that makes a lot of the math in electromagnetism a bit easier, but no, it's mostly the magnetic monopoles thing. You can rotate away magnetic charge, but you can't rotate away the truth. There is something strange on this plot that maybe you've noticed. All the particles fall on a straight line, no matter how you rotate them. That's what makes it possible to put them all on the electric charge axis and have no magnetic monopoles. This is a pretty mysterious experimental observation. Why haven't we ever found a particle, say, here? If we did, then the existence of magnetic monopoles would be undeniable because it would be impossible to get all your particles on the electric charge axis. This is what people usually mean when they talk about the search for magnetic monopoles.
I'm going to level with you here. Admittedly, the experimental evidence is... it's not quite there yet. But no matter, because we have something better than experimental evidence. We have the Dirac quantization condition. Here's a strange fact. Electric charge is quantized. It only comes in integer multiples of electron charge E over 3. So plus or minus E over 3, plus or minus 2E over 3, plus or minus E, and so on. Why only integer multiples? Why not E over 2 or E over 5 or any other fraction? There's no good explanation for why electric charge is quantized. Unless you account for magnetic monopoles.
Imagine a magnetic monopole exists and has magnetic charge G. Now, pick any electrically charged particle in the entire universe. Say it has electric charge Q. No matter how far apart the two particles are, the the electromagnetic field associated with this configuration carries some angular momentum, specifically angular momentum equal to the magnetic charge G times the electric charge Q divided by the speed of light. Quantum mechanics tells us that angular momentum is quantized, so this angular momentum comes in integer multiples of a universal constant called h bar over 2. That means that Q must be an integer multiple of h bar C over 2G. The electric charge must be quantized. And because this setup works the exact same way for any electric charge anywhere in space, all electric charge would need to come in integer multiples of the same constant, h bar C over 2G. In other words, if there were even one magnetic monopole anywhere in the universe, electric charge would need to be quantized because angular momentum is quantized. This is called the Dirac quantization condition. And why else would charge be quantized? I don't know any other good explanation, so it must be magnetic monopoles. Big electromagnetism knows this, and yet they still try to hide the truth. It's outrageous. It's a travesty. It's a conspiracy to sell more bar magnets, and I won't rest until the entire world knows the truth, that magnetic monopoles are